Did you know that to register your business, you can't just yell, "I'm starting a business!" If only it were that easy. Fortunately, I'm here to walk you through how to make it government official with your business. If you're more of a reading person, check out our articles below. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to see the rest of our series, Ready, Set, Goals. Okay, are you ready? But are you really ready? I suppose you might be wondering, why would I want to register my business and make it official in the first place? Well, by registering your business, you can protect your personal assets in case anything goes wrong, and you can get certain tax benefits. Plus, registering your business is one of life's most beautiful moments. You don't have to register your business, and that's okay. You can still run a business without registering one. However, you could be held personally liable and have less legal protection. All right, with that out of the way, let's go over everything you need to do. Step one, choose a business structure. Click on the on-screen links to learn more about this part. Essentially, you need to decide if you're going to be a sole proprietorship, partnership, LLC, and all that good stuff. I'll make it easy for you. If you plan to operate under your own name and don't plan to hire employees, a sole proprietorship may be right for you. If you plan to open a new small business with a partner, a general partnership may be the right call. Make sure your partner is as committed as you are though. After all, it is a 50-50 commitment. If you plan on starting a family, and by that I mean hiring employees to help you run your business, an LLC is likely the best option. If you're a medium or large business and you plan to raise venture capital or equity debt, a C corporation or S corporation may be the right fit. Ugh. Step two, find a location. Every good relationship has to start somewhere, so you need an address or PO box to tie your business to so you can retrieve government documents and file taxes. Step three, register a business name. When naming, shoot for something memorable and ownable. If you're a sole proprietor or partnership operating under a different name from your legal name, you'll need to file a DBA. Step four, register with the IRS. This step may seem scary, but don't worry. The IRS is nothing to be afraid of and will probably even support your new relationship status. Plus, the IRS gives you a federal employer identification number, or EIN. This is like a social security number for your business and is necessary for filing taxes and bank accounts. Step five, talk to your state and local government and let them know your plans so you don't break any laws. Step six, apply for relevant business licenses and permits. Some businesses may require you to have certain permits. For example, if you're serving alcohol, you're gonna need a license. Once all that is done, there's only one thing left to do, run your business. And with that, you've just made it official. I always cry at business registrations.